Hey, forever trying to figure out another way to explain stuff. Combining probabilities. Combining probabilities. What if I want to combine, well, I've got some independent events and I want to combine them. What's the probability of A happening and B happening if they don't depend on each other? Let's have a look. Whoa, it gets busy. All right, look. I like my bags of marbles. I haven't lost my marbles yet. Here we go. Let's do my bags of marbles. Where are they? All right. So let's determine the probability of drawing a red marble from bag one and a green marble from bag two. So here's the way you do it, right? To calculate it. Well, let's do it by using the counting method. All right. Pretend you don't have any fancy formulas. Let's just do the counting method that we've learned. You know how to calculate probabilities. So we got to do the number of ways that we can draw a red from the first bag, that's red one, and the number of ways we can draw a green from the second bag. And then we got to divide that by the total number of ways that we can draw any marble from both bags. All right, so that's easy. What's the probability of drawing any marble from both bags? Well, it's 3 ways to grab a marble there, 4 ways to grab a marble there, so the denominator is easy. There's 12 total ways, right, to pick out any marble and then any marble. How many ways can we draw out a red one? All right, so let's see. Let's use the fundamental counting principle, right? There's one red one here, so there's one way to pick that out times the number of ways to pick it out here. There's one way to pick it out there. So there's one way to pick out a red marble from that bag and a red marble from that bag. So that's going to be 1 over 12, or 1 12th. So there's a 1 in 12 chance that you'll pick out a red marble from bag 1 and a green marble from bag 2. So we did that just by counting the marbles. But guess what? We could have just calculated the individual probabilities. Did you know that the order in which you multiply and divide doesn't matter? So if you go 1 times 1 and 3 times 4, it doesn't matter what order you do. You could go 1 divided by 3 times 1 divided by 4. Well, the 1 divided by 3, isn't that just the probability of drawing a red marble in the first bag? And the 1 divided by 4, isn't that just the probability of drawing the green marble in the second bag? So guess what? It works out to be the same thing. So I kind of just demonstrated to you that the probability of drawing a red from the first bag and then drawing a green from the second bag is the same as the probability of drawing a red from the first bag times the probability of drawing a green from the second bag. It works out to be 1/12. So those were independent events. Bag 2 had no idea what bag 1 was up to. So for independent events, the probability of event A and event B, both happening, is equal to the probability of A times the probability of B. Let's look some more at it here in case you're not convinced. All right, so there's what we said. For independent events, the probability of A and B, of event A and event B happening, is the probability that A happens times the probability that B happens. So now you don't actually need to count marbles. Right? You don't need to have trees and all that stuff. You don't have to count things. All you got to do is use the formula. Let's show you another demonstration here. You ready? Here we pause this if you want. Boom. Look at that. Let's do the same bags of marbles. They're independent, again, independent events. What happens in this bag and what happens in this bag? Neither bag knows what happened. So we're going to do independent, that is separate draws from the two separate bags. So the probability of a green in bag one and a blue in bag two. So we switch it up a bit here. All right, so it's going to be the number of greens in bag one times the number of blues in bag two, because that would be how many ways you could pick a green marble and how many ways you could pick a blue marble. And remember how the number of ways to do two things, right? If there's some number of ways to do one thing and some number of ways to do another thing, and you want to combine them, you multiply them together. and then we divide by the total. So let's do this. It's still 3 times 4. But this time, the number of ways you could get a green marble, the number of greens you could get is 2. And in the second bag, the number of blues is 1. So it's going to be 2 out of 12, or 1 out of 6 this time. So there's a 1 out of 6 chance that we'll draw a green marble from bag 1 and a blue marble from bag 2. Which, funny enough, is the same as 2/3 times 1/4, because the order in which you multiply and divide doesn't matter. So instead of going 2 times 1 is 2, and 3 times 4 is 12, we could go 2 divided by 3 times 1 divided by 4, and you'd find out that when you do that, you still get 2 divided by 12, which is still 1 divided by 6. So there you go. I just demonstrated it to you again, that if you want to know the probability of something happening and something else happening, you just multiply the two probabilities together. Those are for independent events. Or, of course, you know what? You could have drawn trees, right? We could have done trees as well if you wanted to see trees instead. That this is why we use the numbers instead. Otherwise, the trees can get pretty big pretty quick. But if we'd have done it with trees, if you don't like using formulas in arithmetic, you could have done it this way. Oh, my God. Right? It still works out. If I said, what's the probability of getting a green in bag 1 and a blue in bag 2, I only see one green 1, bag blue 2. Green 1, blue 2. All right? Right? That should be a 2. So it turns out, that's the only answers. All right, so here, just let me fix this up. There, I just had to fix that one up. It's pretty hard to do all of this stuff and not have a boo-boo somewhere. All right. So you can count marbles, you can make trees, or you know what? Just use the formula, for goodness sake. All right, so we showed you that the probability of event A and event B is you take the probability of the one event, multiply it by the probability of the other event, and boom, there's your answer. So now we don't actually need to count anything. We could actually just use probabilities, all right, because not everything you make with marbles. So let's check out Josh here, right? So here's Josh. The probability of Josh passing English is 70%, or 7 out of 10. The probability of Josh passing math is 50%. Determine the probability of Josh passing English and passing math. Right, so you could do like a tree or something, right? So usually I like to give things names. Instead of saying Josh passing English, we'll just say E for English, passing English. And M will be passing math. It's a lot easier to just use single letter symbols than it is to keep saying passing English, passing math. All right, so let's just use symbols as much as we can. We do a lot of that in math. So the probability of Josh passing English and passing math is you just multiply the two probabilities together. So it's 7 out of 10, or 70%, times 5 out of 10, or 0.5. And when you do all that, it's 35 out of 100, straight across the top, straight across the bottom, which, funny enough, is 35%. Sweet. And if you're going to do fractions, you always reduce them. So there's a good example of how to use it, and we didn't have to draw marbles or anything. Well, we could have tried a tree as well, right? We could have done it as a tree, but I think you'll agree that the tree would be a little bit awkward. Here, I'll do it as a tree as well. You'll learn that the formula is probably better. All right, so here's the first bag, right? Here's his first test, the English, right? He's got 10 things, so 7 E's are passes, and the 7 bar E's, not E's, are fails, or not pass, rather. Same here. Then he's got the next test the next day, so completely independent events. So you could draw a tree. Let's not do that. You see, you could do this, right? So this would be called a probability tree, right? I could draw, like, 7 E's and then 7 not E's off of it. But it's a lot easier if you just put probabilities on the connectors here and say 0.7 chance of E followed by 0.5 chance of M. And guess what? You still get the same answers. All right, so lots of ways to show stuff. Trees are helpful. Bags of marbles are helpful. I think the formula is probably just much more helpful. Just multiply the two numbers together. You got it? So probability, independent events. You just multiply the two probabilities together.
Woohoo.
Complete.